Hi, my name is Ryan Jacobs, and I am out here in Santa Cruz County, California, taking a picture of this ship with the Intrepid 8x10 camera that's going to go on this tripod in just a minute. And I wanted to make this video to sort of demystify the Intrepid camera and large format cameras in general. You know, a lot of lay people or even photographers don't know how to use these cameras, but they're actually really fun, and they can do some cool things that even regular film cameras can't. So I'm going to put it on the tripod and set it up. I'm opening up the back part here, and you have to lock everything down. There are little knobs on the side that you can tighten. And then I'm going to lock down the front, get everything all lined up. And then in my bag is the lens for this camera. So I have to pull that out and attach it. And this guy and his dog were both really interested. They both have the same expression as they walk by. He talked to me for a little bit. He was real cool. So here's the lens. I'm going to put it on the front of the camera. Now I'm going to move the bellows out. And the point of this is to focus the camera. So I'm going to look through the back. I have the lens open, by the way, so I can see through everything. And I'm going to make sure that ship is in focus. And now here is the film. So the film is inside that little holder that I'm inserting into the camera. And there's a dark sheet that protects the film from being exposed until I'm ready. Now I'm going to go to the front of the camera, set my settings. So that's the shutter speed and aperture are both controlled on the lens there. I'm going to cock the shutter. And now I can take that protective sheet out. So the film is now inside the camera, ready for the photo to be taken. And at this point, I can hit that plunger, and I'm going to hold it down and count 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, tried and true method, because this is a long exposure. So I'm pretty good at estimating. I think that was about 5 or 6 seconds. And, you know, if it's a little off, you can always save it when you print it. Now I'm going to put that dark slide back in the other direction. That's how I know that I've taken that picture. And here is the photo that resulted. Came out pretty good. So after that, I went over to the Arboretum, the UC Santa Cruz Botanical Gardens, and they have this thing called the Future Garden. I set up my camera there and took a photo of that. And you might see that sign there. One cool thing about this photo is you can actually read the letters on the sign. So with large format film, the film is so big, you get such detail that you can actually read that sign. Pretty cool. So you can also use these cameras in studio. You know, I'm a student at De Anza College in Cupertino, and so I brought in a couple of the students. Actually, one student and her friend came in, and we took some photos. And you can see we have a studio light here that actually hooks up to the camera as well. So I'm getting the light set up and everything, and I have to meter it because, of course, the large format camera doesn't have a meter. So you have to bring your own to tell you how bright the light is going to be. And that's a little prism, by the way, that Maddie is holding on the left. So what we're going to do is put that prism in front of the lens when we take the picture to distort everything and make it look really cool. Dark cloth goes over the back just like before. And there's the photo. So now this is the tank that I used to develop the film. And one sort of downside of these large format cameras is you develop film 1 sheet at a time if you're doing 8x10. So it takes a while, takes 30 minutes for 1 picture. But here it is, and look at that picture, look at that negative. So that whole sheet is a negative. It's not like 35 millimeter film where you get these tiny little photos. That is the negative when you use an 8x10 camera. And so that's really the big advantage here. Because with this negative, you can do so many things with it, right? You could contact print it if you want an 8x10. You can blow it up really big if you want a giant print. Or you can do what I'm doing here, and you can make a platinum print. So all kinds of contact printing processes, like, you know, Van Dyke or cyanotype or platinum printing, open up to you when you have these really big negatives. And here's how this works, by the way. I have other videos on this if you want to check out my channel, but you can see what I'm doing here. I'm mixing the chemistry. So this is a platinum solution, and that's what sort of darkens the print and embeds itself into the paper. And then these next two chemicals are the sensitizing solutions. So they're sensitive to ultraviolet light. That's why I'm doing this, by the way, in a bathroom with the windows blocked off so that there's no sunlight coming in. So the regular incandescent light is okay. That won't affect this chemistry. But as soon as ultraviolet light hits it, that's when it starts to darken. So until you are ready to actually make your photo, you got to keep it away from sunlight. So I'm just going to dump that on the paper, and then you got to work kind of quickly here. I'm going to brush up and down, and I have a little frame to show me how far I'm supposed to go. I used to mark it on the paper, but then I did it so much that I just made one of these little frames. And then I'm going to go side to side. And that's because you don't want to see the actual brush strokes in the final print, except maybe at the edges. So if you go up and down and side to side, you won't get all the same direction when you're finished. And you really want to do this for longer than you think you need to, because you don't want to see any puddles. Sometimes they show up even when you think they're gone once you make the final print, where there are little splotches that are darker than the other. So you really want to brush it in evenly. And I've coated my paper. And so it's still wet right now, so I'm going to put it in a drawer and wait until it's dry. And at that point, I'll be able to take it into the lab and make my print. Okay, so here we are. We're at the lab, inside again, so no sunlight's coming in. I'm going to take my paper out, and it's dry at this point, so I'm going to put my negative on top of it. And this is the negative, by the way, that I took with the prism in front of the camera, the one we did in studio. Going to flip that over and kind of sandwich it in this frame. And the point of this frame is to press everything together so that the negative is really tightly sandwiched to the paper so that it doesn't get out of focus or anything. And this little machine is very cool. This is an ultraviolet light machine. So if it's not a sunny day, you can still make a photo by putting your print in this machine, exposing it to ultraviolet light. And now I'm going to pull everything out and take it over to the chemistry to be developed. And one interesting thing about these platinum prints is even before you develop it, you can still see a little tiny bit of the image on the paper. So here it is. I'm going to take it away from the negative. And there it is. You can see a little bit of the image, but when you put it in the developer, it's really going to pop out. So here we go. And this is the magic part. Look at that. We got a really nice photo. And by the way, I cropped in a little bit. So the image area that I painted with the chemistry is about 5x7, even though the negative is 8x10. And that's because for this image, I didn't want to use the whole entire negative. I wanted to crop in a little bit. And so now it's going into a clearing bath. And that basically washes off all of the UV-sensitive chemistry. So after it stays in this bath for about 15 minutes, it will no longer be sensitive to ultraviolet light. And at that point, you move it to the water, which is what I'm doing with that other print. And then you have to wash it for a long time. So here is the print washer. Once you've cleared your print, you put it in this washer, and you run it for about an hour, maybe an hour and a half. And at that point, you can just take it out and wait for it to dry, and you've got a print. And here's the final print. It came out pretty good. This is a scan, by the way. So the real thing has a sheet of paper with platinum embedded into it, and that's what makes the black parts black. All right, so one other thing you can do with these big 8x10 negatives is you can make regular silver gelatin photos. So This one just comes, the paper comes ready to go. You don't have to paint on the chemistry or anything. And this is the normal way that photographers make prints, even with 35 millimeter film or, you know, 120 film or whatever kind of film you're using. But the nice thing about the big negatives is you don't have to enlarge them. You can just shine a light, you know, and put the negative directly on the paper. And you get this really sharp print because you're not making an enlargement, right? You don't need lenses or anything. It's the actual photo. And so it's just the quality of these prints is so nice. And right now I am attaching that print to a backing board. And then I'm going to press it. And this makes it flat, this whole process. So this is a heat press. Going to wait about 45 seconds for it to get totally flat. Now I can take it out. And this photo, by the way, was one I did without the prism. So I like to take a couple of those just in case the prisms don't work, you know, or something weird happens with the light, because the prisms are pretty unpredictable. So I like to take a straight portrait too, just in case. And the straight portrait came out nice too, so I made a print of that. And now I'm going to cut a mat for it. And this is maybe my favorite machine in the world. It makes cutting mats so easy. And for this one, I actually repurposed a mat that I had already cut but ended up not using. So it's already got a hole in it, and I'm just going to make that hole bigger, that window bigger. So here we go. Shoomp. Shoomp. Shoop. So cool. I also went up. I forgot to show you that, but you get the idea. Now I'm going to tape it down. Check to make sure everything lines up. I guess I wanted to tape it real good here. Then I take two little double-sided pieces, double-sided roll-ups, and those are going to lock down the corners. So in case you've ever wondered how to go from empty blank film to finished print with one of these large format cameras, now you can see. There are actually a couple ways to do it that I've shown you here. And there are all kinds of other printing processes. But the nice thing is you don't have to use computers at all. You can do this all with chemistry and good old-fashioned machinery. So it's a really beautiful process, and I hope you've also gotten a sense of the work involved in creating one of these. So in case anybody ever shows you a print made from a negative from a large format camera, now you know how it's done. Thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel.